Lord manifest on this set. I think I'm Big Meech. Look at yourself, now look at me. I'm self-made.
Welcome to Irrelevant Ignorance, where sometimes our ignorance isn't always irrelevant. And this is this week's episode of the BWF, coming to you live from the BWF Arena in Chicago, Illinois. We have a fantastic show here for you tonight. Some more Summer Rumble qualification matches. And we hopefully will hear from the mystery man, Tonka Zulu himself. Hurt Business making their way down to the ring.
On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 932 pounds, the superstar, Omos, and Bobby Lashley, the Hurt Business.
Omos and the Hurt Business out here after they robbed Big E of his championship last week. I bring to you the newest member of the Hurt Business, the 7-foot-tall giant that helped reassure our almighty Bobby Lashley sits on the throne of this company. Now, we send out a couple of challenges. We want the New Day. Shelton and Cedric will put the Hurt on them. And as a matter of fact, make it a Summer Rumble qualification match. Then in the main event, Omos will take on Big L. Y'all don't deserve Bobby, so Bobby, you take the night off. MVP giving Bobby Lashley the night off after winning
the following contest is a tornado tag team match. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 448 pounds, Shelton Benjamin and Cedric Alexander, the Hurt Business.
The Hurt Business look to take over this episode of the BWF. Omos in the main event against Big E. Now Cedric and Shelton Benjamin will take on the New Day. New Day fighting for their brother, Big E. But even a little more is on the line here, as this is a Summer Rumble qualification match.
And their opponents, at a combined weight of 417 pounds, Xavier Woods and Kofi Kingston, the New Day.
But the winner of this match, both members of the tag team will be entered into the Summer Rumble. So this is definitely huge for the New Day and the Hurt Business to be able to accommodate two spots in that match. Kofi Kingston, a veteran of that match, someone who puts on a show in those type of matches. A 30-man over-the-top battle royal. Xavier and Kofi look to also fight for their brethren, Big E, who unfairly lost his title. Xavier, a former champion as well, former internet champion, along with Cedric Alexander, who is just the power champion, who lost his championship match at Warzone to Mike. But here we go. This match is underway. The Summer Rumble qualification match. A chance to sleep well after tonight, knowing that they would be in that match and represent their team, who seems to be entrenched in war. Rolling elbow there by Xavier. Xavier focusing in on Cedric. Shelton working on Kofi Kingston. Oh! Nice move there by Cedric, able to catch Xavier. Shelton slams Kofi to the mat now. Shelton kicked to the back of Kofi Kingston. Now he's punching away at Kofi. Xavier has Cedric on the apron, punches him. stuns him off the apron. Cedric falls to the outside. Xavier goes out there. Now we have Cedric and Kofi in the middle of this ring fighting away. Still reeling off of our first ever special as we head into our second one. But what a special that first one was, popping our biggest rating here in the BWF history. The New Day were involved. They took on Leo Lee, but were unable to win that match and lose this match. They looked to lose this match to get themselves back on track in the tag team division. But again, to reiterate even more so, if they're able to pull out the Summer Rumble, they'll have a bigger goal if the winner of that one face the champion at Winter Slam. Summer Rumble, August 7th, Summer Rumble. We'll have a special announcement about that video. Kofi looks to be waiting on Shelton to get to his feet. Xavier and Cedric have been going at it this whole match, specifically outside in this corner. Hurricane Rana there now. Kofi helps Shelton to his feet. Tosses Shelton into the corner. The Shelton catches him, but Kofi then reverse. And a drop kick there by Kofi Kingston. Xavier gets into the ring. New Day. Kofi legs to Shelton. He's going for the pin. Here's the count. One, two. What a DDT off the top rope by Xavier that was. I saw that as Kofi was going for the cover on Shelton. Oh, Trouble in Paradise to Shelton Benjamin. That could be it right here. Here's the count. One, two. Shelton's able to kick out, and Xavier tosses Cedric Alexander over the top rope to the outside. Vicious throw. And Shelton has Kofi Kingston up in the air. He drops him down on his knee. Nice kicking away at Kofi. Going to the top rope. Oh, big splash to Kofi Kingston. Nice going for the pin himself with a count. One, two. Oh, Kofi's able to kick out. Shelton tosses Kofi to the corner. Splashes him. And Shelton's waiting on Kofi to get to his feet because he's going to try and end this right now. Misses the knee. Oh, what a springboard dropkick by Kofi Kingston. It looks like he might have bloodied Shelton up there. And he tosses him to the corner. Oh, what a DDT by Kofi Kingston there. Slams his arm against the mat, but Cedric's going for the pin here. Here's the count. One, two. Oh, nope. That's a kick out, but here's Kofi. One. But Cedric kicks out of, Cedric breaks that count up. Now he grabs Kofi. Forearm to the side of his face. Xavier to the top rope. Elbow misses Shelton Benjamin. Now Kofi gets around. Cedric runs him. Shelton has Xavier up. With a big body drop there by him. Xavier, but now Shelton goes for the pin, kicks out, and Kofi's waiting up. Trouble in Paradise to Cedric Alexander. Here's the count. This could be it. One, two, but Shelton breaks that up. But another Trouble in Paradise here by Kofi Kingston. He's on fire. Here's the pin. Kofi going for the pin. One, two, three, and that's it. The New Day pick up this win, and it will earn themselves a spot in the Summer Rumble. What a loss here by the Hurt Business.
Kingston, the New Day!
And here's the New Day celebrating their win, putting on for the New Day, representing Big E, and also earning themselves a spot in the Summer Rumble.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the nation from New York, weighing in at 269 pounds, the Superstar.
Here we are, the nation, the new nation, making their way down to the ring. How cute, the DOD, a mix of the great Ahmed Johnson and the Legion of Doom. Too bad for much of that time period, we made both of them our punks. I think you forgot about me and the Legion's WrestleMania win over you all, but how about we propose a challenge? One of my guys versus one of yours. Big time challenge proposed here by Ahmed Johnson. Looks like D-Lo is
put. And his opponent, representing the Doom, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 254 pounds, the Superstar, Tyson.
But again, it looks like D'Lo has put up Khan, and it looks like Ahmed has put up the young superstar in the making, Ty Tyson. Being supported here by his brethren, DOD brethren, Don Jones, Division of Doom here. In their second week, able to pick up an incredible win in a fantastic match against the Primetime Players. And they called out the new nation. Ahmed Johnson not liking what he's seeing. And we're off in this match. Ty Tyson going to work on Khan. Quick combination out the gates. Khan hits him down low. Nice person. He got a little bit of technical difficulty, but Ty Tyson with a big DDT down on the Khan. Powerhouse Hobbs not too happy about that one. Big time kick there by Ty Tyson. One elbow, two elbows. Look at this charisma. The third elbow there now on the Khan. Ty Tyson going to the top rope to fly. Big splash, Ty Tyson off the top rope on the Khan. Now he goes to pick him up. Punches away, big punches. Now he has him down. Big knee to Khan and tosses him to the mat. He goes on that elbow, stumps on that elbow, bends it again. Another big time stump. Fire out the gate here by Ty Tyson. Working on another combo here. Ooh, what an elbow. Oh, and a drop kick to the knee of Khan. One elbow, two elbows. Big elbows there to Khan. Doing a lot of elbows at Khan in this match. Now he has him up. Hangs him up on the ropes.
One, two.
Oh, but Khan's able to kick out. No, goes for the super kick, misses. His backbreaker by the deceptively strong Khan. We talk about him every time he's in the ring. He's quick, but he's also strong. But now he's dragging Ty Tyson. Nice picking him up. Turns him. Oh, big slam on the Ty Tyson. And puts him up. Oh! Reverse STO down there. Ty Tyson going for a pin. Two. Kick out. Has him up. Oh, look at the strength there by Khan. Bounces off the rope. Big splash there. His count. One, two. Ty Tyson's able to kick out. He's raking up the back of him. Up. then down to the knee. Oh, what a elbow there by Ty Tyson, going halfway across the ropes, man, going for the pin. Two. Ty Tyson getting the support here by John Jones and Ahmed Johnson of the Division of Doom. Oh, what a swinging neck breaker there by Ty Tyson. Nice standing him up on his feet. Oh, and the super kick to Khan, that could be it. His lights could be out. It looks like he's tuning up the band for another one. One, two, three, the band is tuned up. Here it comes. Big super kick underneath the chin of Khan. Here's the cover. One, two. But Khan is able to get his shoulder up. Oh, now kick to the arm. Tosses him across the ring, now kicks to him, the chest of the young Ty Tyson, the young superstar, but now Khan lifts him up, look at this strength. Big power slam there by Khan. Ty Tyson down. Working on that elbow now, Ty Tyson bounces off the ropes. Misses that splash there. Ty Tyson gets to his feet. Ooh, big elbow to the side of the head of Khan. Now kick to the knee. Ty Tyson will lock up. He has him up on his shoulders. Hangs him up against the ropes. As he gets tied to his feet again. Has him up with a huge first FBO. This could be the end right here. What a win this would be for the new nation. Two. Oh, but he's able to kick out. Ty Tyson's not done yet. Misses that one. Oh, a little fancy looking move there by Ty Tyson. Here we go, toward the knee. And he's lifting him up, using that strength again from the dead press, has him up above his head, walks him around, shows him off to the crowd, and lets him fall back down to the mat. Gone here. Stumping him. The new nation must have really been bothered by the words of Ahmed Johnson and the Division of Doom, because they had just lost their tag team championship at Warzone and immediately turned to see what was going on with this DLB tag team. And they are also finding out immediately. But now, Ty Tyson with the kick to the back of Khan. Now he has him on. Oh, steps down on his elbow, picks him up to his feet. Big super kick, Khan hits the mat. This could be it right here, here's the count. One, two, three, and that's it right there. Ty Tyson with a super kick in this match. What a debut for these two men. First last week in a big win over the Primetime Players. Now solving one of the little things they came here for, which was dealing with the new nation. Ty Tyson able to take down Khan. You know this isn't going to sit too well with D'Lo nor Powerhouse Hobbs.
Scheduled for one fall on the way to the ring, accompanied by Malcolm Bison at a combined weight of 543 pounds, the Wolf Pack.
The Wolf Pack coming down to the ring after a successful tag team win last week over Tyus and Ricochet. Champion, the power champion, Mike. You know, I spoke with CEO Meech about you after our match last week, and guess what? I got us two Rumble qualification matches next week. The matchups will be easy too. You will be facing Shikashe, and I have Tyus. But for tonight, he says our chemistry was so A1, And next, he wants us to take on some legendary group of idiots. That Tyus better not have found somebody else to team with. Oh, wait, he's not legendary. Ha! Legendary tag team. They say, let's see who end up coming down this ramp. BWS favorite mystery man, Booker T, but this time he brings his brother, the big Stevie Ray, the legendary tag team of the WCW. Welcome to the BWF, the Harlem Heat. CEO Meech said legendary tag team, he did not mince his words. What a challenge this would be for the Wolfpack, as Mike starting this match off against Stevie Ray. Big slap there by Stevie Ray, but Mike counters with a big punch and a kick. What a matchup we have here for the Wolfpack elite to take on the legendary Harlem Heat. Booker T, oh, what a springboard move there by Mike. Mike, again, who's coming off not only that tag team win last week over Ricochet and Tyus with his partner Sway, but also winning the BWF Power Championship at Warzone. And also impressing the CEO enough to guarantee himself at least an opportunity into the Summer Rumble, him and Sway. Sway will be taking on Ricochet. Mike will be taking on Tyus in Summer Rumble qualification matches next week. But Mike think he's slick. I know what he's trying to do. If he enters the Summer Rumble, that decreases the chances that he'll have to defend that Power Championship at the Summer Rumble. We keep an eye on that situation, but he hangs Sway up against the ropes. Now he's walking him over into the corner, bounces his head off the turnbuckle. Elbows Booker T in the face, smacks against the chest. Now he has it out for a suplex. Big time suplex there by Sway. Oh, what a cute kick to the back. Sway seems to have really found his footing working with alongside Mike in matches. He was struggling a bit as a solo competitor, but maybe this little run as team could be what sparks him. Mike calling Booker right to his feet. Now, Booker, big elbow, big forearm, but a nice ball for an arm submission. Really wrecking at that arm, to be able to get up out of this one. Rolls over, big punches to the face of Mike. Now slap to him, has him up for now. Oh, runs him into the corner and now tosses him to the middle of the ring. Goes to tag in his brother, Stevie Ray. Stevie Ray making his first appearance in the BWF as a whole. Oh, big DDT there by Mike. Now Mike goes to tag in Sway. Booker T made his debut in the first round of the Ron Simmons Classic. Wasn't able to pick it up as he lost to Sway. Lost to Zemo. Oh, what a knee there by Sway. But he lost to Zemo. Quick tag team action, tagging each other in and out, keeping each other fresh. Good work here by the Wolfpack. But Booker T lost to Zemo in the first round. But I don't know how much shame he should feel of that. Zemo was in the final. One. Oh, breaks up the pin. But Zemo is in the final, so he put up a great match against Big E. So there ain't too much shame in losing that match. Now Mike going to the top rope. Oh, big crossbody, but he misses. He gets his knee up. Oh, what a knee. That's a sway. Here's the cover. One, two. Oh, the kick out there. Michael Bookie put this one away. Oh, and a big boot there by Harlem. Now kick away at Mike's leg. Another big kick to Mike's leg. Oh, but misses the elbow drop. Oh, and kicks away. Gets him in the pack there. Mike goes and gets the corner. Oh, wait. Low blow kick there. Referee keep your eye on him. Oh, that one takes him down. Oh, catching the punch in the face. Oh, but now he's going after Malcolm Bivens. What did Malcolm Bivens do? Deserve it? Look at this. Attacking Malcolm Bivens and Mike attacking his teammate. He drop kicks him off the apron. But is anybody going to help Malcolm Bivens? Sway is sitting there watching. Now he tags Sway in and Mike goes to the outside. They all seem to be amused that Malcolm Bivens is getting beat up like this. Now Sway jumps over to the outside and goes over that way, but now he's turning around because he sees him, that his partner has gotten up. Now Sway jumps back into the ring. A bunch of chaos is just pursued. Malcolm Bivens can't believe what just happened. Now he tags in Stevie Ray. Stevie Ray is in this match now. I don't know what just transpired in this. Now he tags oh, big slap there. Goes for another one, misses. Kicked his gut. Another slap. Locks him up. Now he has him up, slams him. Now he goes to tag Stevie Ray in. Stevie Ray is back in now. Sway has him up. Oh, Stevie Ray falls on top of him. Stevie Ray goes to lift him up. Sway sweeps his feet. Sway off. Oh, tried to go for a springboard off the middle rope, but misses. Slams his knee into the mat. Now he's going to the top rope. Booker T is trying to end this right now. Goes for the big splash. Now here's the cover. One. But Sway is able to kick out at the count of one. Now Booker picks him up. Big side kick to the face of Sway. Now Booker's going to the top rope again. He's trying to end this match. Big leg drop off the top rope by Booker. Here's the count. Going for the pin. One, will this be it? Two, Mike breaks up the count. Mike's able to break it up. Booker is tired of that. Rolls him up against the corner. Big slap, punches, slap, punches, slap, punches, slap, punches by Booker T. He goes to kick Sway, but misses. Sway grabs him, snap that. Oh, and a knee to the lower back of Booker T. Mike picks him up. He goes, quick dragon suplex. Now he goes for the cover. This could be it as well. Hit one, two, go! But he's able to kick out. Sway can't believe it. Malcolm Bivens telling him to just finish it off. And so now Sway looks to be trying to finish it off here. Wait on him to get to his feet. He misses the first one. But he catches. He hits him on the leg, and now he catches him on the second one. He has him up, going for the ride. Slams him down to the mat. Here's the cover. His teammate gets to the ring, too. Three, he hits the ropes, and this is Sway is able to pick up this match. What a nice little bit of momentum he's gaining here heading into next week's Summer Rumble qualification match as he will face Ricochet. Mike will face Tyus. Mike tells the ref to get out the ring, and now he attacks the Harlem Heat. Mike and Sway are now attacking the Harlem Heat out this match. Mike kicks him out the ring. He's now instructing Sway to keep going. Sway attacks him. This is the power champion. Sway is now kicking away. Now he gets up. Mike tosses him out the ring. Look at them both. The momentum they're gaining on their way to the Summer Rumble. Mike goes to the top rope to celebrate. Now that we are champs, we look forward to who we'll be entangled with next. That Warzone match between The New Day and Leo and Lee seems to have shot Leo and Lee up the standings. So I guess they're our next challengers.
Henry, I did lead though in the ring.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from South Africa, weighing in at 276 pounds, War Prince.
Conquer Zulu like a madman, running down to this ring for his debut match in the BWF after attacking Zemo in his Summer Rumble qualification match. Tonka Zulu now faces Jay Lethal in a Summer Rumble qualification match of his own. This man's fired up. His glowing pads and King Nation, they call him the War Prince. Now here we go, the bell is underway. Jay Lethal started off with a big punch, but Tonka Zulu now reverses. Tonka has him up. Oh, but he works out. Tonka kicked to big punches by Mr. Zulu. Clothesline. Now lifts Jay Lethal up, big punch. Locks up with it. We're seeing the debut again of Tonka Zulu in a Summer Rumble qualification match against Jay Lethal. Tosses him across the ring. Tonka again made his first appearance on the BWF last week, attacking Zemo at the end of his match. We're hoping that at some point we hear from Tonka. Oh, what a DDT by Jay Lethal. We're hoping at some point we hear from Tonka as to what was the point of that. Good pitch there about Jay Lethal. Whatever the case was, though, he caught CEO attention and immediately put him in a match for the Summer Rumble. Something CEO seems to be thinking about money here. He looks and see Tonka and see big time. Tonka Zulu. Announcers also say he's from South Africa. Oh, what a crossbody there by Jay. Goes for pin one. Kick out there. Summer Rumble in a couple of months. Oh, what a diving headbutt there. Jay Lethal barely caught him. The Summer Rumble, August 7th. Well, we will be having the 30 to man over the top road match, the Summer Rumble match for a chance at the BWF World Championship at Winter Slam. A new star could be made that night, but what a knee there by Jay Lethal. Oh! We'll have some real big important news on the Summer Rumble coming soon and venue of choice. Oh, what a headbutt there by Tonka, busting open Jay Lethal immediately. Oh, but misses the knee there. The blood might have fired Jay Lethal up, but he definitely beat him. Oh, and what a beautiful spine buster. Shades of Triple H. Now he's going to the top rope. He's going to fly. Throwing his hands up. Here we go. Big elbow, but misses. Tonka turns it around. Now he goes to pick him up. He has him like a crucifix. Oh, what a big powerbomb there. One, two. Jay Lethal's able to kick out. What a big power bomb there by Tonka. Now he has his foot on his neck. Oh, and then a kick to the back of the neck of Jay Lethal. Misses the running forearm. Now Tonka clubbing blow to the back of Jay Lethal. Now he's stepping on his fingers and then steps on his elbow. What an offense here. Oh, and he goes for a spear, but he's caught by Jay Lethal into a DDT. Now he's lifting Tonka up with a big elbow, with a punch. Now he has him up, but oh, Tonka reverses it. Now he's locked up. Now he has a big belly-to-belly suplex by Tonka Zulu. Now he's going to the top rope. Oh, misses the diving headbutt. Shades of Zemo there. Oh, but an elbow there by Jay Lethal. Now he goes to lift Tonka Zulu up. Rolling. Punch there by Jay Lethal, old school moves. Now he goes, kick Tonka, punches him, he's in a combo. Tonka punches him. Tonka gets reversed. Now he's working on him, going for a big clothesline there by Tonka Zulu. Now he lifts Jay Lethal up, leading away. Oh, goes for a spear again, but Jay Lethal catches him. Jay Lethal, for a person that never seen Tonka perform, really has that spear at least counted. Jay Lethal gets a turnbuckle and throws Jay Lethal to the middle of the ring. This is actually a massive win of Tonka Zulu. Goes for the big kick there by Jay Lethal, misses. Tonka has him up, but Jay Lethal reverses. We seen Jay do that to Zemo last week. Oh, what a DDT there, planning. Tonka Zulu in the middle of the ring. Jay Lethal's now waiting for Tonka Zulu to get to his feet. Looks like he's gonna try to end this. Has him up. Oh! Slams him to the mat. Now he goes for the pin. Here's the count. One, two. Oh, but Tonka Zulu's able to get an arm out. What a match here on the debut of Tonka Zulu. Now he picks a big DDT, planting Tonka Zulu in the mat, in the middle of the mat. Now Jay's going to the top rope, looking to finish this off right here. Looking to end up with that big elbow. Here's the elbow, but he misses the elbow. Tonka Zulu gets to his feet real quickly. But Jay kicks him. Tonka kicks him back. And now Tonka has him up. Looks like he's going for another one of those crucifix power bombs. He has him up high. Real high, look at the height of that. Now he's down. Here's the count. One, two, three. And that's the end of this. Tonka Zulu will advance to the Summer Rumble. He's earned himself a spot in the Summer Rumble.
My name is Tonka Zulu. I come from the people of the Battle of Asanwana, in which the Zulu army took down an English army, one of few defeats they have taken. I have come to take that same type of control over the BWF, and I see no one better to start with than that perpetrator, Zemo.
Tonka Zulu sending a message to Zemo there that he's going to start with him. But the Summer Rumble is definitely on the map for Tonka Zulu as he qualifies after this big win tonight. Celebrating this win, he now exits the ring. Again, Tonka Zulu is able, but there's Zemo. Zemo's watching this, he's keeping a keen eye on Tonka Zulu himself. You know what time it is now.
Scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from Florida, Jade.
Jade Cargill making her way down to the ring. After interrupting Bianca Belair's match last week, after Bianca declared that she is back and looking for gold.
I don't give a damn about Bianca's wishes and desires. That's my BWF Women's Championship. Bianca, I think you may have forgotten. I pinned you in the Queens of Wrestling match in the first episode of this brand. So you enjoy the back of the line, honey. I should be next.
Jay, with a strong message sent there to Bianca Belair, tells her you're at the back of the line. She's still at the front. It looks like she has a match here against Cameron.
And from Los Angeles, California, Cameron!
Cameron making her way down to the ring. Member of the Funkadactyls along with Brodus Clay. Looks to get herself quick started in the women's division, and a win over Jay Cargill would do just that. Let's see if she's able to get that accomplished. Especially with Jay focusing on someone else and Bianca. Here we are underway this match between Jay Cargill and Cameron. Bianca Belair made her return last week, taking on Naomi, taking her down in a terrific match, an amazing match, actually. Naomi, former partners with Cameron as well. So maybe that was going into Jay thinking of taking on Cameron. If you could beat Naomi, I could be her former tag team partner. Look at the strength here of Jay walking around Cameron and lets her flop down to the mat. Now she has her up. Looks like she's going for like a lion tame of some sort. Now she has her turned over. Now this could be the end right here. She can make her tap. She could break her in half. Look at her. She's down riding the table. Oh! Nice leg strength there by Cameron, able to flip Jay down, but tosses Jay head into the mat. Kicks her in the rib. Ooh, big knee to the face of Jay Cargill. Now slams her elbow. Holding, helping Jay up. Oh, but now elbow there by Jay up her own. Oh, big German suplex there by Jay. Very clean. Now kicks at Cameron. Cameron misses there. Jay works on that ankle. Nice kick. Now helping her to her feet. Big slaps. Big knee. Cameron goes and jumps into her. Oh, what a arm drag out of a split there by Cameron. Terrific athleticism. Got a drop kick to the back of Jade. Slams her arm into the mat. Kick there by Jade though. Oh, looks like she's gonna try to slide underneath Cameron, but Cameron catches that with a boot to the face. That could have knocked her out cold there. Now Cameron, gets caught by a boot by Jade there. Keep getting caught by them boots. Get thrown across the ring. Now she's wrecking at the neck of Cameron, really turning her head sideways. Drives into the mat. Oh, what a big boot there by Jade. Goes for the cover, hit the pin. One, two, go! Kick out there by Cameron after the big boot by Jade. Cameron not too happy about that. Lifts her up. Oh, but moving too quick. Got reverse. Oh, but now there's a reversal of her own. And Jade, knee to the, as she has done like a palm. Oh, what a slam there by Jade Cargill. The terrific strength on display again. Has her up. Oh, Cameron's able to reverse that. Goes into her again. Has that split arm drag again. Slams Jade's arm into the ground, goes up. Kick to the back of Jade. Big elbow. Slams her arm against the mat. Now she's helping her up. Kick to the midsection, has her up in the arm. DDT. Massive DDT by Cameron, goes for the cover. Here's the cover. One, two, go. Jade's able to get a shoulder up. Cameron's not too happy. She thought that would have been the end of this match. Now she's slamming Jade's head into the mat. Misses that kick. Jade's going for a clothesline. He finds her face into a face buster X Factor. Now he's going for the pin. Here's the count. One, two. Jade's able to kick out there. What a match these ladies are putting on here. Cameron goes to the top rope. Oh, goes for the elbow on top of Jay, but she misses. Jay slaps with big punches. I know Bianca's somewhere watching this, and I know the BWF Women's Champion Sasha Banks is somewhere watching this. Oh, Jay misses the big boot. Cameron ducks her, swings around, has her up, crosses her over her head. Now Jay lifts Cameron to her feet, tosses her across the ring. Now she's really wrecking at the neck of Cameron there. Cameron picks her up again. Oh, there's another big boot by Jay Cargill. That could be it. Here's the count. One, two, three. Oh, but Cameron's able to get a leg up and force Jay Cargill off of her. Cameron catches her leg there. Arm grip on the leg dragger. Now she's dragging Jay to the middle of the ring. Goes for it. Oh, split into a cover. Here's the count. One, two, go! Jay tosses Cameron off her. That split was too disrespectful for a real pin on Jay. Now Cameron's waiting on Jay to get to her feet. Terrific match here by Cameron. Jay catches her. Now she looks like she's had enough. She's gone. With her, oh, but an arm drag again by Cameron getting out of there. Punches Jay into the corner. But what a win this would be for Cameron. An upset. Oh, but a shoulder block by Jay stopping that momentum. Here's the count. One, two, three. And that's it right there. That shoulder block pretty much just took Cameron and knocked us completely out. Up a win here and sends a message to Bianca Belair and Sasha Banks.
Losing that match was unfortunate. Even though I didn't tap, I should have been in a position to stop it. But there's a stench around that Wolfpack and I'm not fond of it. Next week, after I beat Mike in that Summer Rumble qualification match, I might set my eyes on his Power Championship. I want that belt back. Around one of y'all waist and I don't give a damn who. This Saturday, y'all are in a triple threat match and whoever wins on fight night gets a title match on the BWF. I'm sick of this.
CEO Meech is getting tired of his lackeys, Mason Mark, but here's Big E.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring. Representing the New Day from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 285 pounds, Big E!
The first ever BWF World Champion, Big E Langston, who was robbed of his championship last week at the hands of the Hurt Business, the entire Hurt Business. I won't even give Bobby credit for that. But Big E looks to get a little bit of revenge against the man who did himself come down there and ruin the match for Big E.
And his opponent, accompanied by the superstar from Lagos, Nigeria, weighing in at 400 pounds, Omos!
Omos making his official BWF debut in this match, taking on Big E, who he robbed last week. Look at the height of this guy, this giant. This is definitely going to be a tough task for our former BWF World Champion, Big E. But I'm sure Big E is extra motivated to get this done. New Day members Xavier Woods and Kofi qualified for the Summer Rumble earlier in this night. Oh, tosses Omos, fighting in the name of Big E though, as the Hurt Business tried to apply a cool takeover on this BWF episode. This is not the NWO. This is not WCW. We will fight for the right to take this company over, but with powerhouses like Omos, they might have a chance. Look at this strength. Catches Big E there, just slams him to the mat. But Big E's trying to use some quickness here. Takes Omos down. Nasty elbow off the top rope to the back of Omos. Now rolls him over. Goes for the cover. Looks to end this now. Omos able to kick out there. Really working on Omos on this apron now. That has him up for a kick. Backbreaker side slam there by Big E on the harder side of the ring. Now these men are violent on the outside. Omos has him up. Oh, all the way slamming Big E on this hard, hard surface. We hope in our next BWF special we'll have better matting, but until then, they need to stop it. Now he has him up. Oh, slams him. I think he almost never fall on his knees and fall on this floor, though. Now look at this wrenching Big E back like this by Omos. The big Omos. Look at this strength by Big E to tear out of that. Now Omos is just thrown into the corner. Now Big E tells him, come get into the ring. Omos obliges and gets up to go get into the ring. Whoa, and a big boot there by Omos to Big E. Oh, but smart move there by Big E going to take it down the leg of Omos. Now he's trying to drag Omos. Now he's about for Hulk, going for the big splash. Big splash there on top of Omos. Going for the cover. This could be it here. One, two. Omos is able to kick out. Big E is super upset. He thought that was the end of this. Omos is up on his shoulder. Big E over there by Big E. That could be it right there. What a strength there by Big E. One, two. Omos is able to get his shoulder up again. Now he's going for the top rope. Now he's clapping. He wants Omos to get to his feet. Oh, goes for the splash, but what? Oh, wow, look at this strength by Omos catching Big E in midair and slamming him to the mat. Yeah, he has him. Oh, nice takedown there. Wrestling background for Big E and this full display. And the Omos trade blows. Misses the boot. Oh, that suplex there by Big E. Now he's pumping on his chest. He wants Omos to his feet. Look like MVP might have put a chair in him, but it won't matter because Big E with another big in, and that might be it. One, two, three. Oh, but Omos kicks out again. What is it going to take to put this giant away? Nice to his feet. Big E has him up. Oh, look at that blow there by Omos. Now Omos has him up, but Big E reverses into a DDT. Now he's on the back. Goes and gets the rope now. MVP is up on the rope. The referee loads the chair. He throws him out. The big splash. But now the referee's running over to try and get the count. Here's the cover. One, two. After all that time dealing with MVP, that could have been it right there. I swear we counted to seven. But Big E is not ashamed. He has him up. Going for a big end, and here's a third big end in the Omos. This might be the one to put him away. Here's the count. One, two, three, and that's it. Big E's able to take down Omos and put him away. Finally, after three big ends, there's an MVP distraction. What resilience by our former champion. We are nothing but proud of him. Celebrating a big win here. But that Bobby Lashley's supposed to be off tonight. Big E gets outside of the ring. Bobby Lashley's supposed to be off tonight. Now he has Big E in a bear hug. MVP runs over. Big E is tapping out. That bear hug made Big E tap out immediately. Omos is still down, but Bobby Lashley is attacking Big E. But Big E reverses. Now he's kicking Bobby. Now he's working on Bobby. Big E seems to have the upper hand now. MVP is in a shambles, but now Bobby has him up for quick suplex. What a suplex there on the Big E. Now he's lifting him up. Yeah, oh, but Big E tries to fight out of it again. Now he has him locked up with Big E. He's taken down. Now here's him up for another strong suplex, strong face suplex on the Big E. Now he's lifting Big E up again. But Big E tries again. He's fighting. Big E's so resilient. Now he's going for his own suplex. He has him up. But Bobby gets around that suplex and has him up. Big German suplex there by Bobby Lashley. Bobby Lashley is now on top. The Hurt Business ends on top after all, no matter what happened tonight. The Almighty